Hi guys, this is Sharat again. So in my previous tutorials, I showed you how to create a website and how to host a simple website on GitHub pages. So it was so simple that it just had one file. So if you want to see it in my repository test, it just had one file called index.html and a CNAME to redirect it. That's all. So what if you have more files? Maybe CSS files, JavaScript files, or image folders. So how to upload them? But obviously you don't have a direct upload option in GitHub, but you can do it using an application called GitHub Desktop. So I will leave the link in the description, so you have to go to the link and download it for your desktop or Mac and install it. So once you have installed it, you should get something like the one I have here, a blank application. And what you should do is you have to go to the options and you actually have to log in with your credentials. So add an account and give your username and password, the one you used for GitHub. Okay, so now what you can do is you can create a repository using the plus symbol here. You have create option selected, and if I want, I can clone the ones I already have. So you have seen that I have test, red gadget, GitHub, Emerald, and contact. So those are the ones I have in this repository. So these are the ones. So they are the ones showing up here. If I want, I can clone them to my local computer, or if I want to create a new one, I can name something. Maybe I want to create a new one and have all the files inside it and host it as a website. So let's name it my first website. So call it anything, doesn't matter. So whatever changes you make inside this folder will be reflected in the repository. So let's create it. So it is created. So what I do is, I'll see where it was created. I have to open it in the Explorer. So it has created in this folder. Actually, it's in users, my name, document, GitHub, my first website. And it has already some files. They are gitignore, I guess. So you don't have to worry about them. You can add any number of files here and sync it with your repository. So once you're done, let's add a simple file just to show how it works. New text, red gadget, and just a test. Okay, so save it, close it. So we just have one text file, and let's close this. So here, if you come to the changes tab here on the top, you see that it shows you what change you just did. You added a text file and you just entered just a test. So you have to enter some summary. Maybe like added a text file. You don't really have to do this. And commit. So once you commit, you have to publish it here. Usually this icon will be sync, become sync once you publish it. Okay. Maybe it's asking for a description of my new repository. I'll just give it as new repo. So let's see what happens. So it is syncing now. Okay, so let's go back to the repository and see if that has changed here. So if you see here, I have a new MyFest website repository. If I open it, I should have the test file redgadget.txt, and there it is, just a test. Okay, so we successfully synced a text file. What if we have folders? Will they sync too? Yes, they will. And what I will be doing is I'm gonna sync a full website which has folders and images and everything to this repository and see if that is gonna reflect as a website. And make sure that it will go to GH Pages branch. For now, it doesn't have any GH Pages branch. We can create it even through the application if you'd like to. So click on this branch kind of thing here, icon, and create a new branch, GH pages. So it will be created. So once we have GH pages branch here, we can commit any changes to that branch. So now let's have a full website files, maybe a HTML5 files. Where can I get that? What I prefer is HTML5up.net. So I will leave the link in the description. And they have a number of websites here, and you can download any of them, whichever you like. What I like is the first one called Hyperspace, and I have opened the live demo here. So this is how it looks like. Fairly simple. It has a nice scrolling effect, and it has everything I wanted to. So I'll just download it and see what files it's gonna have. Okay, now that the download is complete, I'm gonna open it up. So it has some, folders called images assets. It has some files. What I'm gonna do is extract them all to some folder here, download folder. So now I'm gonna copy all the extracted files. I'm gonna paste it in the, folder that we synced. So this is the folder. It just has redgadget.txt. So I'm gonna copy them all. Okay, now that the changes are made, it will reflect the changes. You can see that you have added so many things. There are so many files inside. It is showing everything. So make sure you are in GH pages branch and hit commit. Okay. So now it is committed. Just publish. Syncing. It might take a while because you have so many files. So the blue bar here shows the progress. So once I'm done syncing the files, I'm gonna go back to my repository to check if they have come up. Okay. So I should have all the files that I just synced. Let's refresh. Okay, it's not showing it yet. Let's see if this has synced. Okay, it's taking time to sync. Okay. Oh, I'm in the master branch. Okay, I'm gonna change to GHPs. I'm sorry. Okay, now it has. So what I will do is I'll see if this has been hosted as a website. Let's see. And there you go. You have your own website, which you just synced, you just created. It is hosted in this URL. If you want to change it to some other custom domain name or custom URL, you can refer to my tutorial 2 or 3 maybe. I will leave the link in the description so you can watch that to change it. And you can change these things, whatever the name and everything it has, images and everything, and make it your own website. So I hope you liked the video. Please hit thumbs up and subscribe. I'll be doing a lot more of these. Bye bye.